Refrigerant recovery can be one of the most time-consuming parts of servicing an ACR system, but with a good understanding of the equipment and methods used, you can make it easy to do fast refrigerant recovery. We'll start by taking a look at the basic equipment that you're using. You're working with your hoses, your manifold, your recovery machine, and your cylinder, but there's some other details that are important for safety and for speed. With the refrigerant hoses, you want to make sure that you're using large 3/8 diameter hoses, not these little quarter inch hoses. These are great for charging because they restrict flow, but with recovery, they get in your way. So start with a 3/8 diameter hose, such as this short length, which reduces any lost refrigerant between the recovery machine and the cylinder, and still has quarter inch fittings, since that's what we're working with in most cases. The rating on the cylinder matters as well. For example, if you're working with R410A, you don't just need a 4BA rated refrigerant tank, you actually need a 4BA 400 rating. This means it's got a 400 PSI working pressure. Make sure that you're using a recovery cylinder that is rated specifically for the refrigerant that you're working with. Beyond just the rating of the cylinder for its working pressure, the capacity of the cylinder matters as well. You want to only fill a cylinder no more than 80% full. This helps reduce the risk of explosions or venting. When working with a new recovery cylinder, you want to make sure that it's been pulled into a vacuum before adding the first bit of refrigerant. In fact, many cases when you first get a new refrigerant cylinder, it's not actually going to be in a vacuum, sometimes even holding positive pressure, maybe with a dry nitrogen charge, and there could be other contaminants in the cylinder. So make sure that you've first evacuated the cylinder deep, below 500 microns with a vacuum pump to reduce any non-condensables of moisture. When working with a cylinder that already has refrigerant in it, make sure it's the same refrigerant that you're pulling out of the system. You don't want to mix refrigerant, otherwise you won't be able to get it reclaimed. These are just some of the many details that affect your ability to quickly and safely recover refrigerant. Be sure to watch our other videos on using clean evacuated cylinders, connecting for full flow, and purging the lines to make fast refrigerant recovery easy.